Afternoon, whatever time of the day it is for you, it's morning for me. Anyway, we are about to throw this Skyline on the trailer and take it for a wheel alignment. So Matt's going to do a wheel alignment for us on it and adjust the coils and height and everything. So we'll
sitting nice and level.
Yeah, see how that goes. But yeah, enjoy us struggling with it. We got to throw it on the trailer and take it over and go from there.
All right, guys, all loaded down, strapped up, ready to go. Off for a wheel alignment. Oof.
Righto, so we've finally made it over here to Matt's workshop and we're here to do the wheel alignment.
Yes.
So we have got it on the hoist already. Matt's over there playing with stuff.
We've had it on the hoist for like 20 minutes now.
Yeah, stuffing around, but we're just measuring heights and so on. But yeah, we've got to start the wheel alignment now, which Matt's playing with. But we'll go from there. We'll show you what the wheel alignment was. It was pretty out.
It was.
All right. So that's what the back was, or is. It is pretty wonky, but
wonky donkey.
That's what you get for not playing with it at all. So yeah. It's not bad though.
It's not too
I've seen
bad,
worse.
But...
All right.
How's it go, dude?
I thought it went vroom, 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 vroom.
Ain't no rotary, mate.
I love rotary.
Oh, I need a rotary in my
mouth. Are we done, dude?
Yeah.
I need either a rotary or a
mouth. Alright, let's start it.
No, don't start it.
Why not?
Give some juice.
Do the two-step. Bum, bum, bum.
You weirdo.
Alright, I'm gonna do it.
Nah, so wheel alignment's finished. It's pretty decent now. Hey Matt.
Yeah.
From what it was.
Need some camber arms in the back.
Yeah, so we're gonna get some more adjustable arms in the rear. Front's alright.
They have some pretty gnarly camber on the rear.
Yeah, it's got 4.5 degrees on one side and 3.5 on the other, and that's pretty much maxed both ways for them. So trying to just even them out. So there's obviously something a little bit wrong there, but some adjustable arms will tidy that up.
A little bit of a bent control arm or a bent subframe by the looks of it.
Yeah, something weird. So we'll throw it back on the trailer, take it home, and
do some skids.
I think next is tune and then
skids.
Tune, engineering, and then once it's engineered, rego.
You can see the towing on the back.
So I don't know if you guys can tell. Camber and toe, and then it's different on that side, so. And then again. Back on the trailer.
pulled up back at home and unload this thing and go from there, I suppose. Got to put it back on the hoist. Got to do some little final touches on it. Got a slight power steering leak where it goes onto the pump. And then also nip up a few arms, which are really hard to get to with the wheels on and so on. But we'll get that sorted. And then a couple other little things, and ring Haltech tomorrow, have a chat to them about wiring in the WB1 wideband. And then it's set for a tune. Once it's tuned, I think we will go off to get engineered. So right at the end, very, very close to being finished. So we'll go from there.
Why would I die?
Because you have a very expensive car behind you.
And in one.
And in one, yeah. You're right, come straight back. At work.
Of our little adventure for today. It's all wheel aligned and done. So we just, yeah, as I said before, got the tune and then our engineering and so on. So not too much left to do on it. So we'll get there eventually. As for now, Caleb's just starting to pack up the trailer and gonna do that and then take him home and go from there. So thanks for watching. Like and subscribe as usual. Ring the bell. The next couple will be a little bit more interesting, I promise. Yeah. Although this may well have been interesting for some, it wasn't interesting for me. Jokes. Had to do it all. Anyway, guys, thank you. See ya. It's all the same. Some things never change. Couldn't stop and say no.